Hi, I'm Linda Klein, and I'm a co-owner of the Hilburn Springs, that beautiful jewel that's here in Bradford County, one of our oldest towns, and it's so precious. It touches my heart. I'm very with the people and the environmental thing, but like the lady from Mulberry has spoken, there's also a human cost, a health cost, and it's immense. I've done a little bit of research. I found a story of a man that worked at Occidental and what he has experienced and the things that can happen to you in terms of the health effects is just monumental. And I made a copy because it's, you know, I could spend a half hour talking about it, but I made you all a copy of this.
Whoa, careful.
Whoops. Okay, thanks. Anyway, it well can be noted by reading this story of Mr. Gary Pittman and what has happened to him from working at Occidental for 20 plus years. And then I took the liberty of making those copies for you because it would take way too long than 3 months to tell you about it. But it can be noted that neither Occidental nor the EPA ever did much to alleviate the suffering of this man and all the fellow workers that worked at Occidental. And they haven't corrected the environmental violations that were rampant in their operations. Like White Springs, you know, both the town and the spring itself are all but dead now because of that phosphate mine. And the future looks even bleaker today just because what's going on in our federal government. President Trump appointed a man named Scott Pruitt as head of the EPA. Scott Pruitt was the Attorney General of the state of Oklahoma. He sued the EPA multiple times. And first thing he did was call for a 33% reduction in the EPA's budget. So they're not going to help. They're not going to protect us. It's going to be up to us because they're all for leaving big business free to do whatever they please in order to make a buck, you know, and the consequences begin. So, you commissioners are the best and perhaps our only hope to avert the catastrophes that could follow if we permit this thing. Right now, only you have the power to prevent this from happening. It's up to you guys. And I urge you to treat the health and the well-being of the people of Bradford County as a sacred trust, a trust invested in you by the hundreds of people, who voted you into office. And we're counting on you to do what's right for all of us, not just the four families that are standing to profit from this.
Thank you, Mrs. Collins.